All right, you know that you're getting ready to have some content ready for people when it's time for the yearly classroom awards this year. Some Viper pistons, along with some other accoutrements provided by P1 Automotive. Thanks to Alex for real. That's super kind of him to send me this stuff. I greatly appreciate it. I think what we're going to do is take the rods off, and there's two cylinders with the rods. I've got the rings off. I'm going to weld the rods together and make a like a golden scepter of knowledge, and then I am going to weld upon the domes of the pistons themselves, and we'll do that to get another award going. I'm not totally sure in my head what I'm going to do with this, but it should be kind of neat, I think. So we'll see how that goes.
All right. Piston separated, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's kind of smoking too. There she blows. Got the one rod in the background there.
Okay, I've got my rods evened out here with a grinder, and a little bit of yellow stuff on them is from the non-lint free Kirkland Signature microfiber towels that I use with the acetone, so whatever. But I think we'll go ahead and heat this up and give it about all it's worth and just pile the rod in there. I probably will try and put a tack on each side and maybe one on each end. So maybe six tacks total to try and keep this thing from moving all over when I weld it. And we'll go from there. We'll see how this works. All right, you can see my relatively weak tacks here. I'm not, again, this is not gonna be a structural application. This has to be able to withstand some 14-year-olds, which, as many of you know, needs to be stronger than you'd think.
All right, I'm not sure how well you can see this, but I'm relatively happy with how those welds turned out. For the minimal cleaning and preparation I did, I think it's very decent. I also paid very little regard to the post blow. I mean, these aren't stainless, so who cares? But I'll probably clean these up and go. One of them is actually very even. The other one's got a bit of a bow to it, but I don't wonder if that's from the actual grinding rather than the welding. They didn't seem to move around a lot with those little tacks I did, which kind of makes sense given how thick they are, but whatever.
I'm certain you can't see it on here, but maybe ever so slightly. There is a question mark there. Had a kid that's just a phenomenal question asker. So we're gonna do a little thing for him. Maybe you can tell his name's Jack. I don't know. Makes sense that a kid with a normal name would be good at asking questions in math. But nonetheless, there it is. We're gonna weld this thing up using some, I guess that's what. 16-inch rod from Harbor Freight, and gonna crank up the AC frequency to not penetrate too much, get a little bit more depth on it, go a little bit colder on my passes, and I am gonna try and fill this question mark up here, do the outline, but hopefully that's like two dabs worth, and then just a circle here for the dot. And then we'll try and get that name on there the best we can. So we'll see how this goes. Honestly, if it's like my last couple aluminum projects, it should go pretty well.
Couldn't really get their names on there. Maybe I could do the skirt if I'm feeling brave. I did, our buddy Jack here got his in, and I think that camera looks a little better than this one. I don't know. This one's bigger on the piston, but whatever. And there's the arrow for the kid who went up the most, the biggest gains. Probably could have made that arrow a little nicer, but I did the best I could. Hope the kids like these. I will paint them gold, and we'll see how that goes. I do need to get more stainless going, as you can tell. It's not going the best. So, either way, but aluminum, I gotta tell you, I'd like to think that, especially through here, along there and there, like those are some pretty evenly spaced dabs. And for doing some relatively, I mean, this is just, these are pistons, used pistons. Come on now. Pretty happy with that. I mean, frankly, at this point, it looks like if you give me a straight line, and some clean aluminum at least, so I'll give you something decent. So I'm not gonna scoff at these, that's for sure.
All right, we can talk about the welds all day, but what really counts is recognizing the kids who work their tails off all year to be successful. And of course, that also means that the school year has come to an end and it is time to make a lot more Shelby Dodge and in general working in the garage content. So don't forget to like and subscribe and stay tuned, because I've got a feeling this summer we're going to have a ton of stuff for you guys. Thanks a ton for watching.